Welcome to the Potter's House Christian Church, a place where the potter puts you back together again, a family that are called to the love of God and one another. Grow with us on this journey
God
of life.
God richly bless you as you take this decision. I am under a
group. I want to really congratulate men who decided to stay in the principles of God. You know, the whole country is crying about men who are abusing their children, abusing their wives. And this is, I want to talk to them, to the men in particular, to congratulate you, to encourage you, to tell you, I know it's not easy to grow in a family, bringing up children in the midst of challenges. You don't have resources, enough resources. Your children want this and that, you cannot afford, you cannot bring it. And sometimes it's so heavy, it's so painful. You live under pressure. But let me tell you, don't you give up. You live with men who easily yield up to the bad ways. But you are staying with your wife, married to your wife. You decided to live a life, a godly life of not cheating your wife. You need to be congratulated. You need to be saluted. I know things are not fine. The economy of the country bounced back to hit your purse. Things are not just okay. May you still remain a man. May you still be strong. And I declare that things will be fine one day. Things will turn around for you. And don't you give up. I love this scripture in Proverbs 20. In Proverbs 20. Don't forget that God made you the head of the family. Don't forget that you have not been voted to be in that post of being a man and the head of the family. God trusted you. And the good thing is that He wired you with the ability, the wisdom to drive your family. My prayer is that God should provide you with wisdom on a daily basis to deal with situations. Don't you give up. Don't you give up. I know what is to hold on and holding on. I know I'm a man. I brought up 4 girls. It's not that things were easy. It's not that things were smooth, my friend. If you sit down with me, I tell you storms that hit my life, but I decided to live this kind of life that I'm living. Not only for myself, for the name of the Lord also. You know, there are certain things that I would not do for God's name's sake. And somewhere I saw God blessing me because of I decided that. I love this scripture. Proverbs 20 verse 7. If the just man walk in his integrity, and his children are blessed after him. Proverbs 20 verse 7, the just man walks in his integrity, his children are blessed after him. Powerful. He lives after his integrity. He lives by the principles of God. He lives by God's word and commandment. He does not just pull this way and that way wild. He lives in his integrity. Yeah, somewhere maybe friends mock at you, Varuskaya like this, and but you know it's keeping your life in the integrity. And the Bible says, such a man, his children are blessed after him. That living right in this world turns your life to be a blessing. It makes God to bless you, even your children. I'm not only talking to fathers. There are women who are single parents. There are women that you are bringing children up, you are a single mother. Live a life of integrity. This will attract blessing upon your children. But the Bible says in this chapter and verse, it says, a just man lives after his integrity. A just man talks of a man who has been justified. Don't forget on Naluwe and Aweb. We lived a mess life. We lived a corrupt life. But coming to Jesus justified us and made us just men. And after receiving Jesus, we walk in integrity in the path of the Lord. And never look down upon that. It is what is bringing blessings upon your family, your children, upon your everything. With these words, I want to challenge and encourage every man. Bamba no makushisa. Hold on. Don't you give up. Display your love. Display yourself as the head. You are a man, meaning that you are a manager of your family. You are a manager of your family, an administrator of your family. You are a negotiator. To negotiate for your family, your wife, and your children. May God make you strong. Give you strength to walk after in your integrity. It's not foolishness to pick up your Bible and get into the car and say, I'm going to church. Integrity. It's not foolishness to pay your tithe. That is integrity. You know when I do that, God will bless me. It's not foolishness to give, support God's word. You live in that integrity of a just man. And the Bible says, that will bring a blessing even upon your children. I know what I'm talking about. I know what I'm talking about. I've seen the grace of God upon my life. I decided to leave. I mean, from that township life, I received Christ. I know friends laughed and mocked at me, but Rabba Wapaisa. There's a moho. Ulata style. Yo pila njani, lokshin, wo pila jwang. Kara, uli jwalo, di mediki che. But I decided to receive Christ. And I decided to live a life of integrity. My friend, listen to me. I've seen God blessing me. And Luwena, God will bless you. Bless you, bless your children. I see your children succeeding because of the lifestyle you are living. I see your children succeeding because of how serious you are carrying God's work, how committed, how you offer to God's work. With these words, I want you to remember, a just man lives after his integrity, walks in his integrity, and his children are blessed after him. The children will remain blessed. There will be no door that will be locked against them. Every door of blessings will be opened. You remember a man who said, is there no man in this place? He was talking of Mephibosheth. And I want to bless that man who his father did us good. He did well. He carried God's word. I want to bless him. May you live after your integrity and know that is an investment for the blessing of your children. I see your children's future blessed, opened, doors open for them. They will never suffer. No wonder David says, I was young and now I'm old, but I've never seen the righteous forsaken. You are a righteous man. You are a just man. God will never leave you nor forsake you. And I've never also seen his children begging for bread. Banabanga will never suffer. The good seed that you are sowing today, carrying God's word, serving God, living a life of integrity, is an investment. It's a seed that will pop up and your children will benefit out of it. Be strong and God richly bless you. Amen.
Yeah, let me take this time to greet you all in the name of Jesus. We want to thank God for again this day. I have a long scripture, but I want to bring it together. And I know this is something that we preach several times, but God put this in my spirit this morning from the book of John chapter 8. John chapter 8. Wow. We're reading from verse 1. But Jesus went to Mount Olive. Now early in the morning, he came again into the temple, and all the people came to him, and he sat down and taught them. Then the scribes and the Pharisees brought him a woman caught in adultery. Then the scribes and the Pharisees brought to him a woman caught in adultery. Think about that. The Bible says the Pharisees and the scribes, I believe, these were men who came bringing this woman. When you talk of a woman, we talk of somebody's mother, somebody's sister. We talk of somebody's aunt. And the Bible says they came in, where found Jesus teaching, and they just put this lady right at the center just for a show off, to expose her. They never cared whether the children are here. They never even thought of, let's call Jesus and discuss this issue with this lady somewhere with Jesus, and let's hear this man. But the Bible says they just came in the church. Think about that. Neighbors and friends, people who hated this lady and those who loved her, family members, this man cared less. And they put her right in the center. And the Bible says, and they said to Jesus, "Teacher, this woman was caught in adultery, in the very act." They present the case, maybe aloud. Or, "Teacher, wait a minute. This lady was caught in adultery, in the very act." That tells how deep this thing was. They say, "in the very act." In other words, but I'm asking, fine, the case is here. When you see the brutality, how bad these men were. Keep pushing. But I think Jesus was smart. Jesus was smart. He did not quickly say, "Where is the man?" Jesus did not rush into. He just kept it for a certain time. But no, this lady was caught in the very act. And then according to Moses' law, this lady must be stoned to death. I'm trying to imagine his children, his relatives that were there. They knew that the Lord doesn't play games. They knew that these guys are going to break every bone of her body. Leanna, this lady knew, "I'm finished. I'll be lying here under the heap of stones killing me." Her life was finished. And I can imagine some ladies that were in that church. Everybody says, "Sure, I thank God that I'm not that lady. I thank God I'm not that lady." The lady stood no chance of survival. The lady stood no chance of survival. I wish this message to go to every woman, you know, every woman in the country, in the world, to hear this. To hear this, that in the midst of men who are abusing women, there is a man who protects women. I wish somebody should get this message. In the midst of all men that have messed up with who raped men, who raped women, who killed women, who are saying this woman must be stoned, somebody need to know, but there is a man who stood on behalf and protected this lady. Cover her. Maybe you're saying, but she's wicked, she's an adulterer, she's an adulteress. And Jesus would say, just a minute. Hey, send somebody to hear this message that of all the men that were there, that were carrying stones to stone this lady, there is this man called Jesus. This is the message to every woman that is carrying the pain. You've been hurt, you've been wounded, you've been hated, you've been raped. But I'm here to tell you, there is a man that loves you. There is a man who wants to stand on for your case. There is a man who wants to step in and say, wait a minute, you can't kill this lady. You can't crush this lady. And that man, my friend, listen, lady, the name of that man is Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. You owe him a love. You owe him an embrace. You owe him a second thought and think about him, that Jesus loves you. Now the Bible says, they said to him, this lady was caught in the very act. And I was reading this, getting, or maybe she was not only caught. She was not only caught. She was trapped. Like many of us who are trapped in sin. Trapped in sin. Men are trapped in sin. Women are trapped in sin. Boys are trapped in sin. She was caught because she was trapped. You know, we're born trapped in a sin. We were born trapped in a sin. Trapped. We could not shake ourselves out. We could not pull ourselves out. The power of sin had us. Before this lady was caught up in sin, was first trapped in sin. As the Bible says, we're born sinners. Trapped in sin. We're born from the womb of sin. The only thing we could know, it was sin and lies. That's our nature. Trapped in that. Before this lady was caught in the very act, by nature she was trapped. And that's why Jesus had to learn mataka. Listen, this lady was caught in the very act, and they say now, according to Moses' law, this lady must be stoned to death. And then what do you say? I love this portion of the Bible so much. What do you say? You know, it doesn't matter what people say. What matters is what Jesus says. Did you hear what I'm saying? It doesn't matter what people say, even about the church. What matters is what Jesus says. It doesn't matter what people say about your life in Christ. What matters is what Jesus says. It doesn't matter what people say about you, your ministry, or whatever, pastor. What matters? It's what Jesus says. Pandavavare, Jesu. Jalo yakamula wa Moshe, this lady must be stoned to death. Now, what do you say? I love this one. Hey, bayagata mo gamsele, bayagata mo no sa chanel. Yeah, and Jesu are right. Lovana, they are trapped in sin. Abatsivi. They are trapped in sin. Jesus Robana, okay. Mogaralina, who's now a Lord is trapped in sin? Let him be the first one to stone this lady. Gamogaralina, who's now a Lord is trapped in sin. He has no sin. Let him be the first one to pick up stone and we stone this lady. Ah. And the Bible says, I love this one. Here they were, and these men were convicted. They are being convicted by their conscience. That is verse 9. Then those who heard it, being convicted by their conscience. They just are, no. He's not trapped in the sin. Pick up this, let him be the first one. The Bible says these people, Matswalo Abona. Mara, But at least these people, matswalo a bona a sa phela man. Eh? Le ga ba motlisitse jalo, but matswalo a bona a sa phela. O na le batho ba bangwe, there are people's conscience are dead. This guy said, Jesus, or no. Mowle, now is now as now listen. Let him be the first one. Bible, here they were convicted by their conscience. Kore matswalo a bona ba botsa re le wena, you did this. You know you don't qualify to stone this lady. You don't qualify to pick up a stone. Maloba, utsuche chalete, maloba, robeche lemsadi ya mutomo. Maloba, you did this and this. Matswalo a bona, at least asaphela ere batswa one by one go tloga ka o mogolo. At least batswa le matswalo a o phela. But we are living in days mo batswalo a batho a hwileng. You know that? People who do terrible things. Monna mongwe a re ke mokhuta wa batho who can take ba ka tšea lesea. Lesea ba le beya godimo ga setofo sa o fisha, ba tswela pele ba ripa manala ka nail clipper, ngwana a itšhatšharela matswalo a hwile. Re phela ka ra batho ba ba jalo ba matswalo a hwileng a sa pheleng. Tell me where we will fell like I. Because the Bible says your sin will find you out. Your sin will find you out. Let me tell you, my friend, you may do these things, but your ending will be horrible. Your ending will be horrible. Even now and I would repent and say, Mudimu, do something, forgive me and change my life. So shall it swallow like so shall it swallow like a kipile. I would rather die when I look at kipile, bupilo, bukibupilang. Bupilo ba rape, bupilo ba ubula, leba sadi. Kiriki munna, look at me. God, help me. Change my life. Change my character. Here, Bible, ban na bale. Ba tula ke matswalo a bona a phela. I'm challenging you as a man. Eba le letswalo la o phela. Have a living conscience. Yeah. May God raise up men like you who repile that you can live. When you see a young girl, you see your daughter. When you see a woman, you see your sister. You know you are married. I mean, if this lady arasa urat asa, why kill him? Why kill her? And I'm here to remind you, will torture you. I'm living to see the end of your life. I'm living to see the end of your life. The truth is this. This nature has the tendency to arrest you. This nature has the ability to arrest you somewhere. Has the ability to put you in a corner. To go to buy, to pay for your sins that you have committed on this earth before. Somewhere you will have to be tortured by the circumstances of this world. I always tell people, if you send Joseph to Egypt, circumstances will send you. Ulubana babu Josepha utakukumana ulega peta luena usatibu utilejwa uregistre ngwana renwa muisha repeta ubulaile your sister bele circumstances will make you somewhere luena pay the price. Even now and I would say no, I need to change. God make me man enough. God help me and make me a man enough. Here are people who are planning, orchestrating, and let this lady be stoned to death. Jesus, I don't know. And the Bible says, they went out one by one. Washala Jesus. Your Bible at the center. Washala mudira dibuola. Le Jesus, I normally say, wa shala mudira dibile mogau, grace and the sinner. Yeah, that's where kereng basadi ka moka o ka reng kebe nkebe re ka emanyana la re a re bitse basadi ba theletse an advocate. Yabasadi, a man who advocated, who stood to protect a woman. Fine, Jesu Nazi, okay, if she's committed that, we are got Jesu, my friend, listen to me. Jesu utlejiba tubaba jualo. Jesus came for prostitutes and thieves and murder and killer. Jesu utlejibona to forgive them and change their lives. In the presence of Jesus. And the Bible says, and Jesus said, whoever accused you, did they destroy you? Did they kill you? Did they condemn you? Said, you are a master. No, say, they did not. Arelina, I don't condemn you. Are go. Musadola never believed it. When Jesus said go, he was trying to say, I'm setting you free. This is an advocate. This is a man, Jesus, who stood. I think this is what all women need to know. I don't care how corrupt you are, how sinful you are. Mokabangwana, Jesus loves you and he wants to protect you and he wants to transform and change your life. He wants to liberate you. He wants to set you free. I don't care you're caught up. Maybe you said you're a kishakamili, but I'm here. The Lord can set you free. I'm a prostitute. I'm about to say, come to my church. Come to my church. Come to Potter's house. But Muruti, I messed up. I've killed so many children. But I say, come to Potter's house. But Muruti, I'm corrupt. We were all born corrupt. Muruti, you don't know what I did. You and I, you don't know what I did in life. I was a mess. And I came to Jesus. He came into my life, changed my life, forgave me of my sins. He set me free. Our boy, go and sin no more. Think about that. Yeah, but when to banana or no, Musadio, Erfeta Morkovar Molela, I list to boy, let me tell you, Bamana Aja, walking majestically. Set free by the lamp of God. And the Bible says, when the Son of Man shall set you free, you'll be free indeed. Let me tell you, hey, Jesus, I'll go and sin no more. Let me tell you, Uba Sarum said, Samaya, we are told to chasibi. Don't be sin conscious. Uba, I don't know. Hey, Jesus, I'll go. Uba, I'm setting you free. Or and sin no more. Uba, I'm empowering you over sin. Sin will never put you down. You are empowered to conquer sin. And Jesus, go and sin no more. He was trying to say, I'm setting you free. And when the Son of Man shall set you free, you'll be free indeed. Go and sin no more. I give you power over sin. I give you power over works of the devil. I give you power to conquer the forces of darkness. This is the message that women need to know. There is a man called Jesus who loves you no matter how bad you have been abused and raped and maybe you've been done whatever. And let me tell you, there are people who wish you were dead. And let me tell you, God loves you. And we still really feel the pain, carrying the pain of the families that have lost their loved ones that were killed by men. This week has been a very bad week. This month has been a bad month where women were killed by people that said they loved them. And the families have lost their daughters, their mothers. We're standing with you. May the grace and the healing of God visit your family. And just leave, bury your loved ones, and let go, and let God, and release them to into the hands of God. Tell yourself, just stretch out your hand and let go, and remain with the peace of God. Let God heal you. Let God heal you. And in the other hand, I can tell you, this world has become a bad world. It's a pity your loved ones left this world in this manner. I wish it died in a better way, but it happened, my darling. All I can tell you, God heal you. God heal your family. God heal every member of the family. And may God give you peace of mind, and especially to know that you are not a murderer. You know, the hot ball is left in the court, in the hands of the murderer. The guy is carrying a hot ball, will carry it for the rest of his life. He'll never have peace. Lena, forget, just forget, forgive him and say, God, you'll see how to come with it. May these things not torment you. May God heal your mind, and somehow God with his godly divine touch heal your brains and your mind and make you feel good somehow. I know it's not easy, but with God it's possible. But I'm talking to men. What kind of a man are we? What kind of man are you? What kind of a man are you that you can rape and kill and destroy? I wish you be a man. And I understand, Doris, because of the nature in which you're born. You're driven by something. You're driven by something to kill, to rape. And let me tell you, this thing, unless God steps in and set you free, you'll find yourself trapped in under a truck. Kuri ulika fasa truck, suffering for a couple of hours, paying the price of people you tortured. You will never survive and make it and go in life free somehow. You'll never go free somewhere. You'll be trapped in a corner. And you'll want to pull out, suffer the pain. Even now and I would repent. Say, you know what, God, I messed up. Enough is enough. I want to be a man. And I want to challenge men in our country, wherever you are. Let us be the advocate of protecting our women, our girls. In our, whether it's your daughter or your neighbor's daughter, let's develop a lifestyle of loving them. Let's not see sex object when we see them. Let's see them as the creation of God, blessing them, doing them good, protecting them. On our young little kids, even if it's at night, that he could go home. He does not know. He's caught up between heart and, you know, he doesn't know who can help me, who will abuse me. May you become a man that I call the right survivors, the man that I call the good survivors, that when men died, you survived. You buried so many people. And you are still alive, you are not buried. Let us know that we are survivors. We buried many people. May we be the right people. May we become the right men. Few as we can be, touch lives of women, of girls, you know, without being romantic or sexual minded. Love them, do them good, protect them. And God will bless you, man. God will do you good. And God will bless your children. God will bless your future. If you become an advocate of protecting our ladies, our girls, our wives and women, may God richly bless you as you take this decision. I am under a group. I'm with a group of men under Bishop Mutimkulu called Men on Track. Men on Track. There's a group of men that we come together and we talk to each other. We need to be men. We need to rise up and protect our people. I'm challenging every man that is here. Let us be men on track. Let us be men on track. And the Bible says, Jesu Ari, go and sin no more. And the lady was set free. And he walked out, forgiven, set free, and empowered. Maybe you are there. I want to pray with you. If you can open your heart and just admit, oh Lord, I failed in life. I messed up. I raped. I killed even killing. I messed up, Lord. And it is because of my sinful nature. And so maybe you think, will God forgive me? Let me tell you, God is a forgiver. God will forgive you. A man who orchestrated the death of a Uriah. After he raped, he slept with his wife and killed her husband. But when this man comes to God, let me tell you, God forgave him, man. And God turned him into something. Today, the Bible is loaded with psalms that were written by such kind of a man. Luena, God can forgive you. God can turn you into something. Just open your heart. And God, I'm going to pray with you. God will change your life, will forgive you. He will come into your life. He will drive your life, will influence your life. He will use you. Pray this prayer after me. Say, Heavenly Father, I thank you today. I've heard your word. Forgive me, Lord, of all my sins. I messed up in life. I messed up in life. I am corrupt, Lord. I lost myself. I don't even know myself. But I'm coming to you, Lord. I open my heart. I receive Jesus as my Lord and my Savior. And forgive me, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that from today you have come into my life. And I believe my life will never be the same again. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. God bless you.
Thank you for being faithful in hearing what God has spoken today. May God's grace abide with you and all the days of your life. Be blessed.
In case you have fallen by the wayside of life, dreams and visions shattered, you're all broken inside.